morning and welcome to St. Mary. Today is Thursday, the 11th week in ordinary time. Today's Mass is being offered for Thomas William Orszewski at the request of the Chorale family. O Lord, hear my voice, for I have called to you. Be my help. Do not abandon or forsake me, O God, my Savior.
Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary and her Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Now, Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Like a fire, there appeared the prophet Elijah, whose words were as a flaming burnt furnace. Their staff of bread he shattered. In his zeal, he reduced them to straits. By the Lord's word, he shut up the heavens and three times brought down fire. How awesome are you, Elijah, in your wondrous deeds, whose glory is equal to yours. You brought a dead man back to life from the netherworld by the will of the Lord. You sent kings down to destruction and easily broke their power into pieces. You brought down nobles from their beds of sickness. You heard threats at Sinai, at Horeb, avenging judgments. You anointed kings who should inflict vengeance and a prophet as your successor. You were taken aloft in a whirlwind of fire, in a chariot with fiery horses. You were destined, it is written, in time to come, to put an end to wrath before the day of the Lord, to turn back the hearts of fathers towards their sons, and to reestablish the tribes of Jacob. Blessed is he who shall have seen you, and who falls asleep in your friendship. For we live only in our life, but after death our name will not be such. O Elijah, enveloped in the whirlwind, then Elisha, filled with the twofold spirit, portion of his spirit, wrought many marvels by his real word. During his lifetime, he feared no one, nor was any man able to intimidate his will. Nothing was beyond his power. Beneath him, flesh was brought back into life. In life, he performed wonders, and after death, marvelous deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Rejoice in the Lord, your justice.
Fire goes before him and consumes his foes round about. His lightnings illumine the world. The earth sees and trembles.
Rejoice in the Lord, your justice.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord,
Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, in praying, do not babble like the pagans, who think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him. This is how you are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If you forgive others their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have learned the Lord's Prayer at a very early age, haven't we? The disciples said, how should we pray? Here, and Jesus gives them this beautiful prayer. Also, he tells them, do not babble like the pagans. Again, we go into the scene of Jerusalem, and many people, really not by their actions, but by the multiplication of all their prayers, think that they're going to win favor with God. I think it's both then again, isn't it? It's prayer and doing good. It can't be either or. By now, all of us understand that's a very powerful Catholic axiom, both and, not either or. We need to pray, and then we allow those prayers to take root in our lives, in what we do and what we say. We can't just be prayerful people in church, and then when we leave here, we're really nasty. We're nasty to people, our tongues are sharp, we ignore people, we're not kind, we're loving, we're generous. So Jesus says, in praying, do not babble like the pagans, who think that they will be heard because of their many words. See, that's a danger, isn't it? Well, the more prayers I say, the more God will love me. He already loves us. He loves us already. What we do is respond to that love. So God already loves us. That's why he's God. He's our Father and we are his children. He already loves us. Winning his love by prayers or good works, as if that's going to make all the difference? No. That's in response of God's love for me. That's in response to God's love for me. And we have to be very careful like that, because Jesus even warns the people of his day. It has to be a good balance. A good balance of time of prayer and kindness. Now, there's another portion of this, right? People that do not pray, maybe do not come to the celebration of Holy Mass, receive the sacraments, and they're good people. In fact, that's what we say, don't we? Well, Father, he's a good person. I know he doesn't go to church. I know he doesn't pray often. I know he doesn't do this. Well, in the same way, there has to be a balance. So we call those people also to test and to make sure that their life is balanced by prayer, the sacraments, and kindness and love to other people. Just like when we say people maybe who go to mass, but they're not kind in their heart. The balance is off. And even all this is good, it has to be coupled with how we live our life. And I think we all understand that, right? And that's what Jesus is trying to say to the people of his day and to all of us. Because how often do we understand that the scriptures pass through time and space? Every age, every culture, it's applicable, right? This is not just applicable to the people of 30 to 33 AD Jerusalem. No. It's applicable to all ages, all cultures, all races. It says, when you pray, say, Our Father. First of all, that threw them for a loop. Because they would never call God Daddy. It would be disrespectful. But Jesus says, do that. He is your Father who cares for you. We have to make sure that our mind and our heart is of the mind and heart of Jesus. That we say, Father, you who live in heaven, hallowed be your name. Holy is your name. And to respect that. If you've been watching the afternoon reflections, I am on a series right now, the Ten Commandments, right? Yesterday I did the second commandment by respecting or hallowing the name of God. The day before we talked about strange gods in 2020. Here in the U.S., Pennsylvania, Montgomery County, our lives. So, how we deepen our understanding of all this. Take a little bit of time today and go through line by line of the Our Father, talking about his kingdom. May your kingdom come. It's here. Absolutely. Maybe not to its fullest expression, but it's here. Because God's here. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. On earth, as it is in heaven. And so when we look at each of these lines of the Lord's Prayer, we really are powerfully immersed into a dialogue with God and with ourselves. And relationship is so important. So everybody, we get through the Lord's Prayer, that those bottom lines. If you forgive others' transgressions, your Heavenly Father will forgive you yours. But if you don't forgive others, what will happen to us? How about if we go to our grave hating people? You know, my sister-in-law, my mother-in-law, my cousin, my co-worker, whoever. What happens if you go to your grave hating them, not forgiving them? Neither will your Father forgive you your transgressions. As merciful that God is to us, he wants us to be merciful to other people. And the only way that we can be merciful is to be immersed in his very being, the prayer, the Lord's Prayer, the Eucharist. Do you notice we pray the Lord's Prayer right before we receive communion? It's a very powerful prayer. As we continue to journey through ordinary time, let us understand mercy. Let us understand God's redemptive love. I personally think that in everything that God showers us with, that love and that mercy are synonymous. And what does love mean? Is it mercy? And what is mercy? Is it total love and understanding who you and I are? to settle with who and I are, but to raise us to a level in which God has created us to be. But sometimes we could say to ourselves, oh, God knows me. I'm just going to be this way. And that's really not the way that God wants you to be. So we could fall into that trap. But God raises us to a dignity that we're called to be. And may we all hear that voice calling us to that level in which God raises us by his grace. And mercy is very powerful, isn't it? Have you ever received mercy, forgiveness, love? It's a very powerful moment. It changes us. It allows us to see the face of God. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the Catholic Church throughout the world, that God will continue to guide us in bringing his word to life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, may God guide them in upholding human dignity in policy and practice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are poor, hungry, or thirsty, may God show compassion upon their suffering and enliven the community to meet their needs. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church gathered today, may God give us courage in leading lives of faithfulness in word and deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially members of this community, may God grant them mercy and everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Mark Worley, Pauline Winterbottom, Barbara Wynn, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Thomas William O'Shesky, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray for an increase in vocation to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pretty gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him. Through Christ our Lord, through whom the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, pray for us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. For those of you watching virtually, now is the time for you to make a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at me spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
Thank you.
Christ's solemnity, and as you've been following, I guess, the afternoon reflections, solemnities in the church have two readings, a Gloria and a Creed. So they're different than a feast, a high. It ranks the same as a Sunday without the obligation. That's what a solemnity is. And but if a solemnity falls on a Sunday, then it just follows the obligation of Sunday. So tomorrow is the solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Powerful feast. You might want to Google St. Margaret Mary Alacoque and the promises that was given to her by the Sacred Heart. Also, this weekend is Father's Day weekend, and we have Father's Day cards available for those who are watching us virtually. If you come on the weekend for confession, maybe you can stop by the sacristy and see Peggy as well. Also, the first Saturday of July is July 4th. People are asking, are we having the same schedule? And the answer is yes. So there'll be morning mass, as usual, as a Saturday morning. And there'll be afternoon confessions, because you know, during this pandemic, I have taken the morning confessions and the afternoon confessions and made them a hybrid of one confession at noon until this is over. And then we'll go back to the two sets of confessions. And then we'll have the 4 o'clock mass as usual. That's all on Saturday, July 4th. So everything remains the same, just in case if you were wondering. Because I know that goes in people's minds and they're wondering, like, is everything going to be? Yeah, we're not like Walmart or any other store. We're open 24/7, believe it or not, even when we didn't have public mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody.
To heaven.
Saint Michael,
the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do battle.